oftentimes we think it's our hormones as to why some people can eat junk food without any problem, and others need to count every single calorie. Understanding your hormonal balance will bring you to the answers to your weight loss goals, and in this video, I'm going to tell you everything about it. Hormones play a crucial role in regulating various bodily functions, including your metabolism, your hunger, and even your body weight. Some hormones that have a direct impact on body weight include leptin, and I want you to think that your leptin is your full signal hormone. It's produced by fat cells and regulates hunger and your metabolism. Two, ghrelin. Ghrelin is that hunger hormone. It stimulates hunger, and it's produced by the stomach. Number three, cortisol. Cortisol is produced by your adrenal glands, and it increases appetite and contributes to the belly fat storage. Four is your thyroid hormones, and those regulate your metabolism and energy levels. Insulin is number five, and it's produced by your pancreas and regulates glucose levels and even promotes fat storage. So an imbalance in these specific hormones can lead to weight gain or even difficulty losing weight. For example, high cortisol levels can cause stress-related weight gain, while low levels of thyroid hormones can lead to a slow metabolism and increased weight gain. I have this client, Tim, and he was a big deal contractor. He was building this huge house and he was under a lot of pressure because the homeowner was dying of cancer. And he had to get this house done so that the homeowner could see it in completion and have it there for his family before he passed on. Tim was doing everything right. He was following the meal plan and he was dropping still about 2.5 pounds a week, which is great. But at PhD, we expect our men to drop easily 3 to 4 pounds a week. And there was nothing else that Tim could do but follow the meal plan. After the house was done and that stress reduced, he was able to pick up the speed and we saw the weight start to drop at that expected 3 to 4 pound range. So the amount of stress that you have and the amount of cortisol that your body is secreting as a result really impacts your weight loss success. Let's talk a little bit about the hormones and how they can impact your weight loss and your health. It's for this reason that if you have hypothyroidism or low thyroid, that you want to visit with your doctor and use medications if necessary. The type of tests that they do also really matter, as the general thyroid panel doesn't take a deep enough look into your real thyroid health. TSH is usually the only test that's ordered, but you want to know more. I want you to be an advocate for your health. This isn't medical advice, so make sure that you follow what your doctor prescribes, but I do want you to ask your doctor if you're looking at your thyroid health to test for these items. 1, free T3. 2, free T4. 3, reverse T3. 4, total T3. 5, total T4, and number 6, TPO and thyroglobulin antibodies. Again, this isn't meant to be medical advice. I'm just wanting to be sure that you are educated and can be an advocate for your own health. Please be sure to follow your doctor's recommendations. There are two other hormones that we specifically think impact our weight loss, and that is estrogen for women and testosterone for both men and women. Let's talk about women first and estrogen. While having adequate estrogen levels is really important for your health, unfortunately, supplementing with it likely won't speed your weight loss, and sometimes it can encourage weight gain. We often think that supplementing with hormones will increase our weight loss speed because many of us experience weight gain when we hit menopause, so we associate it with the drop in estrogen. The real cause of weight gain during menopause, though, is due to symptoms provoked by perimenopause, like the redistribution of fat to the belly, sleep disturbances and loss of muscle mass, decreased activity, and increased social stress. Estrogen replacement can help optimize your health. However, when estrogen replacement is started, most women will reliably gain those 3 to 5 pounds. Intuitively, this really makes sense. Think about the first time your body became flooded with estrogen in puberty. Did you lose weight or gain weight? Usually we gain weight when we go through puberty. This fluctuation in weight gain, though, will often be transient, and estrogen replacement certainly shouldn't be seen as a tool for weight loss. For men, often the culprit to weight gain is touted as low testosterone. An interesting fact about this one is that your belly fat actually secretes a hormone called aromatase, which converts your testosterone into estrogen. So if you carry fat in the belly area, you 100% will experience lower testosterone and higher estrogen levels. Your hormone levels will improve as you drop your belly fat. There are also other lifestyle factors you need to get in place to help your testosterone levels, which include stress management, good sleep, and lifting weights. If you are struggling with carrying excess body weight, then you should check us out at PhD Weight Loss and Nutrition, because that is what we focus on. So schedule a time with one of our nutritionists and we'll help you create a customized meal plan that will be a belly fat reversal program for you. So if you are a man and you're looking to supplement with testosterone, you'll probably find that you have better energy and libido along with an easier time maintaining muscle mass. However, not the expected weight loss unless you combine your efforts with a great, well-designed weight loss program. In summary, bioidentical hormone replacement therapy can help you feel your best, but it's not going to be the magic pill that will help you drop that stubborn body weight. I want to give you a handful of tips so that you can overcome and even cure your dysfunction. Number one, lose the extra belly fat. Drop the carbs that you're eating and let go of the notion that you need to eat 45 to 60 grams of carbs at each meal. You don't have to be keto or Atkins, but you do have to understand what your unique carbohydrate tolerance level really is. Number two, eat healthy fats. Do not fear fat. Healthy fats will help you normalize your hormone levels. Number three, make sure that all of your meals are protein forward. What I mean by that is I want to see 20 to 45 grams of protein per meal. Number four, lift weights, as this naturally helps to regulate hormones. Deadlifts and squats are actually some of the best testosterone producing exercise out there. If you have back pain or you're injured, watch out though. Number five, get enough vitamin D and enough of your B vitamins. Number six, sleep. Short sleep, less than 5 hours a night, reduces testosterone by a whopping 10 to 15%. Number seven, manage stress to get cortisol as low as possible and support your adrenal glands. Number eight, establish strong relationships and companionship. I know it sounds a little bit crazy, but it's shown in the research that if you don't have strong relationships and intimacy, then your testosterone levels can drop. And remember, testosterone is important for both men and women. Number nine, get tested appropriately. Making sure your thyroid is in check will be one of the biggest components to helping you drop the weight with as much ease as possible. So, as you can see, hormones are a crucial aspect to take control of your body weight, but it's not the entire solution to the weight loss equation. I want to update you on all of the parts to take into account in this video. We'll dive deeper into the other segments of a weight loss journey and how you can be prepared to make yours a success. See you there.